Hello and welcome to our family show starring Tascha, our wolf dog. She was actually a cross between a Siberian Husky and a Canadian Timber Wolf. Because of the wolf content, we first studied the breed thoroughly. To our surprise, we learned that she would make an ideal family dog. However, due to her wild, independent nature of inheritance, it would take twice as long for obedience training. Having had two sons and a couple of dogs before, we thought we can handle that. Over the years, that handle became an emotional experience, every bit as much rewarding as the upbringing of our two sons. From our point of view, there was no difference whatsoever. She was raised as a fully integrated member of our family, with her own specific character and traits. As a final introductory word, her biggest pleasures and joys were snow and water, children and chocolate. The last item raised some concern with our vet, but she just loved it. And now let's open our scrapbook and begin with some pictures, because in the first year we did not have a video camera. At the beginning there were four, but our cat soon disappeared. The name Tascha was a shortcut for the Russian princess Natasha. It started with Edmund and Tascha, Tita and Tiger. The still pictures will end after 4 minutes. Here she is about 6 weeks old. For Tascha, I was referred to as Papa, and all the other family members were known by their proper names. Highlighting her first swim, this was one of those memorable things where she got taken in by a little duck, feigning injury and an easy meal. A soccer accident put Dietrich in a cast, much to the delight of Tascha. Her upbringing went through all the normal human development stages, filled with love and laughter, but also mischief and adventure. The first proud moment, Christmas, and a big bone. For a cookie, she could almost stretch out to the height of our older son, Edmund. And snuggling up to Mama always produced more rewards. But the outdoors, and above all snow, were instantly her favorite. She could never get enough play in the snow. Not quite a year, but almost fully grown. This brings a little story to mind. 1 or 2 months earlier than this picture was taken, we were walking in the park meeting a bunch of preschool children. When the kids saw Tascha, they stormed at her like on command, screaming and pushing, shoving and jostling, and Tascha just stood there, soaking it up as if the kids were rays of sunshine. We adults, we were all taken by surprise, remaining motionless in awe. Then we too felt the sunshine that is coming from this meeting. In the coming years, we would have more similar experiences. An older lady said it once like this: I could feel her charisma from 100 feet away. There is a strange magnetic force around her. Anyway, it was nice to know not to have to worry about children. As you can see, she is pretty photogenic and took to picture taking like a pro. Posing for pictures was no problem. Here she is almost as tall as Mama. Now she's taking a piece of chocolate out of my mouth. Yes, in this respect she was spoiled, but isn't she worth it? Our bed was supposed to be a no-no. On the left again, Randy, and pretty soon we opened the door for moving pictures. When it comes to digging, she's always a good worker. And here she is helping me to get to the roots of it. All right, she's doing a good job there. Good helper today. She's really getting her nose into the job. Now, you shouldn't have much problem getting that. Now she's aiming at me. Okay, Tascha, good girl. This time I allow you. Whoops. Since we couldn't curb her instinctive ticking, we used it for practical purposes. We are heading out for our daily exercise run in the park. And as you can see, we use all the equipment that is available. She was extremely intelligent and you could teach her anything. But she demanded respect and acknowledgement. Otherwise, she could be stubborn beyond belief. So the teaching process always went both ways, and our appreciation of her nature grew immensely throughout the years. We were always bewildered of her understanding of emotional things. Don't tell me animals have no feelings. Quite on the contrary.
Non forte si vede il dito.
Ok. Ok.
Good girl.
Brav. Stay. Tascha and Dietrich come home from their exercises and they will go in the backyard where Edmund will carry on with some play.
Come on.
I take time out to relate a story that happened around this time. We were planning on a salmon dinner one day and took the frozen fish out of the fridge, put it in the sink and went out in the garden for some work. A couple hours later, we went back in the kitchen to check on the unthawing process. And to our surprise, there was no fish. Henriette ran a quick double check in the fridge. No, the fish is gone. Then all of a sudden, a light went on. Tascha! The angry cry reverberated through the house, but she was not in sight. Outside was the same thing. Where she was hiding, we did not find out. 2-3 hours later, she would reappear out of nothing, begging for forgiveness with great big puppy eyes, because she knew exactly that was very bad. I unleashed a very stern warning, but it would not remain the only time. Next comes a wilderness camping trip with the boys.
Okay, there goes Tascha. So much for being scared, eh, Bubba? Look at this, huh? Look at that! Not a problem. Oh, and there's Tascha. Scared. Yeah, right. There's Tascha. Whoa, there's Tascha. Yeah, look at that. Look at that.
Your mushroom okay. For you, Bubba.
Yeah, lots of mushrooms. This is the trail going up. And there's Tascha. See, she's not on the leash. Haha, she's not on the leash.
Okay, we're here at our campground. This is our nice cozy blazing fire here. Yeah. Over there, dead man. Whoa, we got that one lit. Yeah, hi Tascha, say hi. Yeah, Tascha. And of course, no footage of campground is complete without a tour of our, well, makeshift tent.
Tascha and the boys were out on a 5-day wilderness trip. Upon the return, we went out to the lake for some summer fun.
Oh, battery dead. Run this thing in. Yeah, that's my lake. And that was way up there.
She was a strong swimmer, but preferred the shallow waters.
Good girl. Okay.
At least once a year we hike to Brandywine Falls.
Sit.
As you see, we're having a little break and resting. Now we see Brandywine Falls from a different angle. Attempting a hike to Singing Pass. Here comes Tascha. She has to cross a little waterfall. Okay, come on.
This hike starts at Whistler to Russet Lake or Singing Pass. I'm guessing about 9 kilometers one way.
Now she goes underneath and Henriette has to go over it. We're passing a section where the trees are covered all in moss.
Tascha doesn't want to come back, so she wants to play in the water. Oh no, she's coming. Good girl.
We noticed quite a number of mushrooms on the way.
What a beauty. And we've been going now for about 2 hours. And Tascha likes the nice chair somebody put there. He's still chasing every squirrel and mouse and chipmunk she sees. And a look back. We see that the clouds are lifting gradually. That's actually 8 kilometers away from the parking lot. Down to Chicamus Lake, and that's the view what we came up here for. Just incredible.
As usual, she has to wrap in the snow.
Tascha is drinking the water. the shaft of a gold mine. This is the end of our hike.
Some interesting shots from the lookout at the Cypress Bowl, Mount Peak in the background, the lions.
This is so-called white snow. Here one can clearly see what air pollution does. The white snow is black. Just rolling in the clean snow made Tascha as sturdy as she never was.
Yes, mosquitoes are buzzing. That bridge has collapsed due to the heavy snowfall.
Autumn is approaching fast and we're heading out to the west coast of Vancouver Island to Rim National Park.
This is what Tascha likes most, pristine wilderness, lots of exploring, and lots of new things to see, and smell, and hear. On this particular trip, we didn't bring any films back from the rainforest because our camera failed, but we made up on other trips. We are turning our attention to Alouette Lake, a place that we enjoy every summer.
Good girl. here.
Tascha especially likes every catch me if you can game.
Good show. Now come back. Good girl.
Some beautiful fall colors before the winter blows in with a heavy snowfall.
We are now in our backyard after the big snowstorm.
Winter was by far Tascha's most favorite season, and we took every opportunity to get out and enjoy nature. She seemed to be immune to the coldness and sometimes slept for hours curled up in the snow. She's looking for Ed to have some fun.
Oh, she decided to come back out the same hole.
So far, 95 was the only winter when we saw icicles on our house.
Okay, good girl. heard the birds.
A flock of Canada geese overhead.
Went through a log, an old log.
Today we explore Lynn Valley.
Camera was still on.
A nice example of previous logging activity.
Nice, beautiful. Okay, go.
Showing off the cross on the tail. Then we visit the shores of the ocean.
A little sandpaper.
And Tascha will have a fun day.
Another flock takes off. There goes Tascha in the water.
If you watch closely, you will notice that this is a game for both parties. For Tascha and the ducks and birds. They know exactly how to lure Tascha in and when to take off. They never fly away far, just to prolong the game. And of course Tascha wants to show off too. Here she comes back for a brief moment before turning her attention again to the ducks.
Ruffling its feathers, it probably will take off in a second. Getting too close. Yeah, there she goes. Now the heron takes off. Just beautiful in flight. We're having a little break, and of course Tascha is waiting patiently. That is my sandwich. better stop filming and go and get my sandwich.
Otherwise, there won't be anything left for me.
One more time. Climbing a vantage point. Coming back. That's a good girl. Today we're in Mount Seymour. It's a beautiful sunny spring day and we're hiking the Goldie Lake. Of course Tascha comes along and she just loves the snow. There she goes. Oh, beautiful. She can't get enough of the snow. That's her domain. She just loves it. And off she goes, back to Mama.
Here comes Tascha with full steam. Watch for the jump in the background. I came up a bit short. The lake is still frozen solid, but showing some cracks.
Yes.
This is what I like. It is my domain. Snow and water, it's my most favorite things. Nice cross on the dale. She doesn't dare going underneath. And a beautiful reflection. And lots of people snowshoeing. 5-6 schools up here. The gardening season has begun and Tascha likes to be included in the workforce.
This is a perfect angle, throw dirt at me.
Yummy grass, eh? Yummy grass.
That year, Randy came for daily visits to play with Tascha.
I'm sure she's comfy.
Yes, this is Mama's bedroom, and she is digging away and ripping the plants out. Oh, yeah.
The picture is not very good, but the way they play is simply joy. They are a perfect match and enjoy their company. Sometimes it might look rough, but they are very careful not to hurt each other. The way they read their body language is phenomenal.
This makes for a good tension release. Oh yeah, Natasha's going painful.
This is it. Go for a break.
Yes, she just volunteered to go in the water. She's just having so much fun. So we start digging it out.
Don't get the door. Go, go.
There's Randy lying down and shaking off, and well, there goes the camera. But our precious little stick. So Randy satisfies himself with the grass. Who's stronger, the dog or Papa? I'll hold my vote with the dog. I would say we have roughly 2.5 minutes left. Good girl. Back to Mama.
The sun is just setting and we're catching the last rays. Good show. Again, a puddle of water is blocking our path. Good girl. some wet fall pictures taken from our bedroom. Then a beautiful sunny day on Cypress Bowl.
Tascha.
That is how I know you.
No, 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 no.
A wind of wonderland unfolds before our eyes. Did you notice the snow level?
I'm standing on top of Mount Strachan, which is about 1,400 meters high, on a beautiful April day, looking down Howe Sound.
A free barbecue. After helping myself to the free barbecue, I head down the mountain and let the camera roll. The sound of me approaching must have scared this guy, so he lay down.
Lionsgate Bridge.
Came home, the sun was down, and we look back where we came from and have been skiing. While in our garden, the blooms and blossoms have arrived. What a difference the location makes. A hollow log and a nice photo op of Tascha. Again, a place we visit year after year, Manning Park.
Rainbow Bridge from a different angle today.
Tascha likes to clean up.
Oh, that's a big one. Beautiful puddle. Green with moss. Oh. All right, she is really working today. Good girl.
By the time you're home, Randy is already waiting for Tascha to play. A foggy layer hangs over the Portman Bridge. Our plan is to hike around Bunsen Lake. Overnight, snow has fallen on top. Oops.
Excellent. Nice help.
Tascha follows her instinct and goes on a mouse hunt. She hears the creatures running underground but has never caught anything. So we let nature take its course and don't interfere. That way it keeps her good in shape and we don't need any extra exercise. Thank you. We are in the Boundary Bay area, and Mud Bay is actually covered by a sheet of ice. Right kind of weather for Tascha. Beautiful. Not a snowball. Tascha is waiting for the next game that Edmond is coming up with.
Good girl. All right.
Our backyard is transformed in a snowy winter wonderland. Tascha watches intently as Edmond carries a heavy load of firewood into the house. A huge stump from a logged cedar tree, probably 70 years ago. The hollow remains of another one. Heavy and a lightweight encounter of similar breed.
We're on a hike on Seymour Mountain.
And got a bit unusual surprise when somebody reported to the ski patrol that they've seen a wild wolf roaming around, and ski patrol chased us down in their skidoos. Luckily the patrol member was a bit more understanding than the private operators of the mountain. The bright sunshine has clouded over a bit, but Tascha still enjoys it, and the snowfall was pretty heavy too that winter. There are holes 5-6 meters deep, and Tascha is pretty careful, does not get too close. Eating the bark and the roots is pretty nutritious. She knows that by nature. It's slippery and icy, and Henriette has to be pretty careful. Tascha doesn't seem to have any obstacles at all. Christmas on our street. This is our neighbor, and here is our house. A few pictures from inside the house, the living room window, homemade decorations. And a demonstration how Tascha does unwrap her gift. What kind of unwrapping is that? Holy smoke, that looks like a war zone. You don't have to do this, man. Finally you get your bone. In her mind, she must have translated the unwrapping as the most important part of Christmas. From the inside back to the outside. Tascha is coming back from visiting strangers. She is mostly welcome, but when she is not, she senses that and keeps her distance. As you can see, we are trying out the feel of snowshoes. Downhill it's still slippery. Here Tascha senses the apprehension of those people and keeps her distance. Good girl, don't frighten those poor people. Thank you. Those snowshoes are still uncomfortable. Here one can clearly see how she drags the hind legs, a sign of aging. That looks much more comfortable. However, when you see these pictures, she's hiding her age pretty well.
Okay, good girl. Now you can move, Tascha, if you want. This is the beginning of April. Easter weekend.
The snow level is up to the roof, over 6 meters. Kids are enjoying themselves by sliding off roofs. It is late and time to go home, but Tascha doesn't want to leave. Eventually, she will run out of steam. I hope. Dogwood, both white and red. In our travels, those conditions happen quite frequently. The ferry terminal, Horseshoe Bay, and what we're about to show you is not a pretty sight in the political history of British Columbia. These new ferries were called the Fast Cats and were a total disaster to the taxpayers, to the tune of almost $500 million. Take a good look. This is how governments squander your money. Thank you. Looking at another side, we are following the abandoned tracks of the Cattle Valley Railroad. That was more than 50 years ago, but the ships were less than five. For the taxpayers, the financial disaster was the same. A very cloudy day, but a nice overlook over Osuyus. Hiking here was quite strenuous, and we're taking a well-deserved resting break. Four hours later, on a mountain pass near Nelson, we make a snowy break. This day was quite eventful.
These are the Otello tunnels near Hope.
This is still a part of the Cattle Valley Railroad, and we are homewards bound. The year the railroad tracks were built, but 20 years later it was shut down. Little Falls. Springtime on Mount Seymour with lots of snow and lots of fun.
Come on, you're not sinking in. Someone's tired again.
Heavy snow load bent a lot of trees horizontal
and broke a few. Nice and warm, and we walk in our shorts.
A very happy individual comes running.
As you can see, it's so warm that I can be in shorts. suit you have.
Yeah.
Looking for Mama.
Chipmunk looking at me.
As you can see, we are at one of our favorite places, Manning Park. And who can wish for a better panorama than this?
In her younger years, the ducks would have given Tascha instinctively a signal for hunt, but now she just looks at them and admires them just like I do. The same with the following ground squirrels. Luckily, we were in our camper when this surprise hit, but shortly afterwards, we were out taking those pictures.
Fireweed with all its fire.
And busy bees. Skunk, cabbage. Autumn is always very colorful, and I fall for it. Then comes the long, harsh winter time, which the following pictures will prove not to be true. Everything has two faces, and here comes the good one. Virgin snow and spectacular scenery are a welcome break from, get this, weeks of rainfall in the valley. But Tascha is living proof there is happiness in snow. She might be sleeping, but her ears are wide open, reacting to every sound. With the eyes wide open, one can discover many beautiful and strange things. An even stranger fog formation hangs over the city, while we enjoyed sunshine all day. A few days later, it is snowing heavily in the valley. We are looking out from our living room window. It's a gorgeous day, and we head out to Boundary Bay. Tascha can hear the mice crawling underneath and is on the prowl. Tascha came up empty, but I've never seen a little bird eating a field mouse, a little vole. This was the only time, and it let me photograph it. There is quite a few animals out for prey, the blue heron and the upcoming bald eagle. Then all of a sudden it's springtime again. Canada goose family. Foolish adventure on a slippery log, but he gets away with it. Chilliwack Lake. The yellow concentration is seeds from trees. The deer looked at us as if it has never seen a human. He's quite startled. Tascha gives a look back. Nature is always changing, and I try to capture that variety, for nothing stays the same, like a bleeding heart. Thank you. Isn't it amazing when one can say, this is my garden, these are my flowers, these are my bees, or my dragonflies. But it also can represent a big problem. Like I mentioned before, everything has got two faces.
Whoa! Wipeout! Whoa! Beautiful!
Tascha preferred resting in the grasses rather than watching the performance. But the coming sunset was pretty impressive to us. Today we're taking a walk on the muddy side, taking a stroll on Mud Bay. An open shell is an invitation for all predators, a sand dollar, blue heron again, there's another one beside it. A crab. Tascha is checking out with her foot. Not really impressed and moves on. So does the grab. I like this panoramic picture with Mount Baker seemingly floating in the air. Just like the bald eagle. A young bald eagle. It takes us to the Okanagan Valley, where we have a couple of hikes planned and also another foray on the Cattle Valley Railroad tracks. Blooming sagebrush, ponderosa pine, this will be our last tour to the abandoned Cattle Valley Railroad, because 2 years later a fire destroyed some of the trestles. So we are pretty happy having this film as a lasting memory.
Crossed about 5 or 6 trestles.
We are heading into some tunnels. Mm-hmm. At the time of building in 1934, the whole project was considered an engineering marvel.
And Tascha is very hesitant, she doesn't go alone.
Throughout the many years we stayed in British Columbia, this was our only fishing trip. The lake was stocked with 40,000 rainbow trouts, but we never got a glimpse of a single one, much less a catch.
This is Beaver Lake Resort, where we try to catch some rainbow trout.
Still on the optimistic side.
We are high above Beaver Lake now.
Tascha wanted to make friends with cows and rolled in their manure. Now we are trying to get rid of the smelly aroma.
It's so
in the evening, I got my first and last lesson in fishing. Come to think about it now, I should have noticed that nobody else was fishing. And look at the water surface, not a ripple, and not a dead giveaway. Tascha was probably also wondering, what the heck I'm doing out there. Now that's better. Beautiful. On our drive home, we pass through the desert-like Nicola Valley and stay 2 days. It was pretty hot, close to 40 degrees centigrade, with a summer storm looming in the sky. An old church made out this point of time. Tascha is well advanced in her senior years. It's her 12th year. At this point in time, Tascha is in her advanced senior years, her 12th year, and is much too proud to show the sign of aging. Still enjoying life to the fullest, but with major handicaps coming up. Quite similar to our own conditions, and that means making adjustments. Enjoy the last outburst of autumn from the Nicola Valley. Another favorite spot of ours in the same area is Kentucky Alleyne Provincial Park. You can see the happiness right away. It is a very scenic place, out of the way, easy hikes and lots to see. A motionless piloted woodpecker is keeping an eye on us. Thank you. interesting rock formations are coming up, with algae providing most of the color. Little snake as we head to our campsite. Oh, nice cool water on a hot summer day. We're always on the lookout for wildlife. Here we catch a loon.
So you speak to me of sadness and the coming of the winter. Fear that is within you now, it seems to never end. And the dreams that have escaped you, and the hope that you've forgotten. You tell me that you need me now, you want to be my friend, and you wonder where we're going, where's the rising, where's the reason. And if you cannot accept, it is here we must begin to seek the wisdom of the children and the graceful way of flowers in the wind. For the children and the flowers are my sisters and my brothers. Their laughter and their loveliness, the clear and cloudy day, like the music of...
Whether small or big, it doesn't count. It's what you see that matters. All of a sudden we hear the warning signals of the marmots and we look around to find them. He looks like the leader of the colony.
Though the cities start to crumble and the towers fall around us, the sun is slowly fading and it's colder than the sea. It is written from the desert to the mountains, they shall lead us.
Also marmots. We are on a day hike in Glacier National Park, and by the time we get back, we are pretty well done, all of us. Back at our campsite, Tascha goes to sleep right away, but we still have to cook. Some photo ops at Roger Pass. Stuffed white mountain goats and the spectacular Tascha waterfalls coming up. Shortly after the falls, we meet this black bear. What a lucky day we had today. Emerald Lake in Yoho National Park. Henriette is getting curious looks because of Tascha and often is getting held up. Our luck is holding up with beautiful sunshine. Picture perfect. Our next campsite will be on the Alberta side of the Rockies. Tascha goes on an inspection tour and then waits for supper. Our arrival at the Kanalaska area is greeted by a little snowfall. The weather has changed for the worse. Today's hike ended at this mountain lake, surrounded by tall mountain. It looks like an amphitheater. Just beautiful. This hike was on the strenuous side because it was quite a bit uphill. At first Tascha didn't know what the boards were for, but she picked it up pretty fast. Here she has strapped herself and needs some help to get out of it. A beautiful opening in the trees. One of the highest mountain passes and the most interesting geological formations I've ever seen. Just look at the fault lines. Amazing. The first moose on our entire trip. Waterfowl Lake. Lake.
Today in a foggy, misty light, but otherwise one of the most beautiful lakes in the whole of the Rockies.
An elk on our campground.
At this stage of the mating season, they can be very aggressive.
For the end of this presentation, we have taken Tascha on the gondola to the top of Mount Whistler in Jasper. We wanted to give her a good look of the world she loved so much, still being able to enjoy everything, and the preview of looking down on us from above. A year later, almost 15, she passed away peacefully with the blessing of all of us, leaving a lot of fond memories behind.
Thank you for watching. Goodbye, au revoir, und auf Wiedersehen.